At 7:30 this morning, KPFK received a call from a woman identifying herself as a member of the Weather Underground.
Hello. I'm going to read a declaration of a state of war. This is the first communication from the Weatherman Underground. Kids know the lines are drawn. Revolution is touching all of our lives. Freaks are revolutionaries, and revolutionaries are freaks. If you want to find us, this is where we are. In every tribe, commune, dormitory, farmhouse, barracks, and townhouse, where kids are making love, smoking dope, and loading guns, fugitives from American justice are free to go. Within the next 14 days, we will attack a symbol or institution of American injustice.
The Weathermen spawned out of the separation of the Students for a Democratic Society, also referred to as the SDS. High-ranking members who held positions in the national office of the SDS began to speak about their goals. One of those members, Mike Klonsky, published a doctrine titled Toward a Revolutionary Youth Movement. The doctrine promoted the idea that young members of the working society possessed enough power to be able to overthrow capitalism. After the publication of this document, the national office began to separate and informally was separated into two groups, one led by Mike Klonsky, who was the author of the doctrine, and one led by another high-ranking member, Bernadine Dorn. The SDS had been an incredibly radical and outspoken group who opposed capitalism as well as the rich police oppression and the war in Vietnam.
Our country was murdering millions of people. Actually, the number is somewhere between 3 and 5 million people. This revelation was more than we could handle. We didn't know what to do about it. It was too great a fact. Every second of my life from 1965 to 1975, I was always aware that our country was attacking Vietnam.
The Weathermen got their name from a Bob Dylan song with lyrics, "You don't need weathermen to tell which way the wind blows." The Weathermen were extremely militant because they didn't know how else to solve the injustice that they faced.
This was that we had to do whatever we had to do in order to stop the war.
The Weathermen sympathized with the Black Panther Party and considered themselves somewhat similar. The Black Panthers were a group of very radical, very militant advocates of self-defense for African Americans. When Deputy Chairman Fred Hampton of the Panthers was killed as he lay in bed by a tactical unit of Cook County, Illinois, the Weathermen issued a declaration of a state of war, promising vengeance for the Panthers.
Battle which followed.
The pigs murdered our Deputy Chairman Fred Hampton while he lay in bed. Their lies, their arguing to the people can't bear up to the evidence that we have that they murdered our Deputy Chairman in cold blood as he lay in his bed asleep.
With this new militant mentality came violent protests. One exceptionally memorable was the Days of Rage, an incredibly violent protest designed to bring the war home. The goal was to create a call to arms for the American public and wake them out of complacency for this war in Vietnam. On October 8, 1969, these rallies started.
Last night, they armed themselves with sticks and chains and rocks and surged through the streets of the Gold Coast on Chicago's north side to carry the fight to the enemy. The rich.
So we thundered out of the park, about 10 or 12 abreast, and we headed down this way. And the first building we came to was a bank, and we trashed every window in the bank. It was all glass, big plate glass windows, inviting, and that was like the signal. That was like Pavlov's bell.
It seemed to be violence for violence's sake, with the radicals making no specific demand.
At about this point, at State and Division, we saw a serious barricade, several police cars, a real mass presence, and we had no out at that point, so we just swarmed into it, and there was a terrible fight right here.
Police generally acted with restraint, but three people were wounded by police gunshots.
Last night was a beginning for us. The ruling class in their Gold Coast decadence will walk their streets a little less secure tonight. If they hadn't dug it before, they'd better dig it now. They are the enemy.
But the victory was short-lived, and there was no real social change. There was no five-year revolution, no quick fix like they had hoped and protested for. Things remained the same, and still are the same. The Weathermen stated that they became violent because of the unsuccess of the movements before them that were peaceful. But in reality, did they make more of an impact than those who came before? When you incorporate violence into anti-war protest, you simply become a hypocrite and become as bad as the war that you're protesting. How many bodies will have to pile up before we open our eyes? How many people will have to die before we listen?
To begin.